Today we will start the new chapter of chemistry, that is the acid, pH and salt. In class 9th, we have studied the classification of matter. What is that one?
That the matter is classified based on the physical property, is categorized into solid. The next one, liquid, and the next one, gas. So the next one, based on the chemical property, what is that one? Chemical property. The matter is categorized into element, and the next one is compound. In this chapter, we will discuss about the compound. That the compound is of three types. That is acid, the next one is base, and the next one is salt.
There, in order to know the presence of acid, base and salt, it means how we are able to detect that the given substance is acid or base or salt. In order to detect them, we use indicator. What is indicator? Indicator is a dye which changes its color in acidic or basic medium. Let us know.
Indicator. What is indicator? Indicator is a dye. Dye means coloring substances. Indicator is a dye which changes its color in acid or basic medium.
To the next, how indicator shows the presence of acid and base? Indicator, I have told you that it is a dye. Dye means coloring substances. If it is a coloring substances, then in order to show the presence of acid or base, it is going indicator. When put in acid solution, it has somewhat different color, and when it is put in basic solution, it has different color. It means by changing color, it is going to represent the acid or the base. Let us know how the indicator is categorized.
Indicator, it is categorized into that is synthetic, and the next one is natural indicator. Natural indicator. The synthetic indicator, we have two synthetic indicators. The first one is methyl orange. Methyl orange, in case of methyl orange, it is the first one, A. It is, it turns to red in acidic solution. B. Its neutral color is orange, and it turns to yellow color when placed in it turns to yellow color in basic.
What we know? When in order to know the presence of acid or base, we use indicator. As the name indicates, indicator indicates the presence of acid or base in a solution by changing color. As I have told you, that indicator is a dye. Dye means coloring substance. And they have a characteristic property to change its color in acidic medium and basic medium. So the next, I have categorized the indicator based on their origin. If it is synthetic, it is of two types. Only two types we have to study in this class. The first one is known as methyl orange. And the next one is phenolphthalein indicator. In methyl orange, you know, as the name indicates, methyl orange. It means in neutral solution. In neutral solution, it is orange. It means its neutral color is orange. It means its neutral color is orange. Or we can say its color in neutral solution. Its color in neutral solution is orange. Neutral solution is orange. To the next, what happens when this it is placed in acidic solution? It turns to red. When it is placed in basic solution, it turns to yellow. It means in acidic solution it is red in color, in basic solution it is yellow in color, and its neutral color is orange. To the next, we will discuss about the phenolphthalein indicator. The next synthetic indicator, that is known as phenolphthalein indicator. If we are discussing the phenolphthalein indicator, then it is colorless in acidic medium and its own color is colorless. But when it is placed in a basic solution, it is colorless in acidic medium. Acidic medium. Or we can say its color is colorless. Its own color is colorless. And it is colorless in acidic medium. The next one is that its color turns to pink in basic medium. Here we have studied two indicators. The first one is methyl orange, and the next one is phenolphthalein indicator. These are synthetic indicator. Methyl orange, it is orange in color, turns to red in acidic medium and yellow in basic medium. Phenolphthalein indicator itself is acidic, and its color in acidic medium is colorless. To the next, when it is placed in basic medium, it turns to pink. We have to discuss certain natural indicator. What are these? The first one is litmus paper. The next one is litmus solution. The next one is turmeric. Haldi. The next one is red cabbage. Extract.
The next one is extract of certain flower. These are hydrangea, petunia, and the next one is zinnia. To the next, we will discuss olfactory indicator. And in that, we will study the first one is onion extract. And to the next, we will study vanilla extract. Clear?
Natural indicators are of following types which we have to study in this class. The first one is litmus paper. The next one is litmus solution. The next one is turmeric haldi, you know. The next one is red cabbage extract. The next is extract of certain flowers such as hydrangea, petunia and zinnia. To the next we will discuss olfactory indicator. And olfactory indicator, as the name indicates, it is related to smell. It means the smell of this substance can help us to know whether the given solution is acid or base. These are onion extract and vanilla extract. We will discuss them one by one. The first one is litmus paper. We know the litmus paper. It turns to red in acidic medium. The next one, it turns to blue in basic medium. Here we know the litmus paper, it is a natural indicator. When it is placed in acidic medium, then it turns to red. But when it is placed in basic medium, then it turns to blue. So next, we will discuss the litmus solution. The litmus solution, it is obtained from a seaweed. It is obtained from a seaweed known as lichen. Its natural color, it is neutral in nature and its natural color is purple. In acidic medium, it turns to red and in basic medium, it turns to blue. It means its color is same to that of litmus indicator. It means the litmus solution. The first one, it is extracted, or you can say it is obtained, it is extracted from a seaweed known as lichen. The first one is its neutral color. Its color in neutral solution. Its color in neutral solution. Purple. The next one, it changes to red color
in acidic medium. Acidic. And the next one. It changes to blue color in basic medium. What we have studied? We have studied about the two natural indicators. What are these? The first one is litmus paper, which changes to red in color in acidic medium and blue in basic medium. We will discuss the next one, litmus solution. I have told you that the litmus solution is extracted from a seaweed that is known as lichen. And its natural color is purple, which is neutral. It means in neutral solution, it is purple in color. To the next. Where it is placed in acidic solution? When it is added to acidic solution, then it turns red and it changes to blue in case of basic solution. Let us discuss about the next indicator, that is turmeric. You know, we use this turmeric in our daily cooking item. What happens when you have a stain of curry on your cloth? Then it is yellow in color. But when you want to wash it by the use of soap, and we know the soap is basic in color, during washing it, when you observe, it color changes to red. To the next one, if you have got calcium carbonate or calcium oxide, you can say, whose nature is basic in basic. When you add turmeric to it, then its color changes to red. It means it can also indicate the presence of a base. It means turmeric which is yellow in color, but its color changes to red, or you can say red is brown in basic medium. The next we will discuss red cabbage extract. Red cabbage extract. As the name indicates, red cabbage extract, it is red in color. It means the first one is that it is red in color. The next one is that when it is added to acidic solution, then the color is red. It means its color is red in acidic solution. To the next. It changes to green in basic. We have studied about the two indicators. The first one is turmeric and the next one is red cabbage extract. You know, turmeric, a natural indicator, its color is yellow. And it changes to red is brown in case of presence of a base. When we add turmeric powder in our homes to quicklime,
then its color changes to red. Or we have observed that the stain on the cloth turns to red when we wash it with soap solution, because the soap solution is basic in color. When we are discussing about the red cabbage extract, as the name indicates, it is red in color and its color is red in acidic solution. The next, it changes to green in case of basic solution. So we will discuss about the hydrangea. The petals of hydrangea flower is usually blue in color. That means the petals of hydrangea is blue in color, and turns to pink in basic solution. This is all about the indicator, which shows the presence of acid and base by change in color. To the next, we will discuss about this olfactory indicator. This olfactory indicator, as the name indicates, olfactory means related to smell. And we have two indicators, that is onion, which we use in our daily diet, and the next one, vanilla, which is a type of flavor or smell given to cakes or food items. How we will know the presence of acid or base? By the use of onion extract or vanilla extract. We know onion and vanilla have their characteristic smell, and when a base is added to it, then its characteristic smell disappears. It means their smell cannot be detected in the presence of a base, whereas their smell can be detected in the presence of acid. It means the first one, we know onion has a characteristic smell